Beatrice Alworoto is suffering from nasopharyngeal carcinoma, a type of cancer which is commonly known as NPC. The cancer manifested 1 year ago. It led to her experiencing constant nose bleeding, non-stop flow of the saliva, coupled with a swelling around the neck, especially in the areas below the ears. She looked for treatment in the local health facilities within Gulu and could get none. Her pain and suffering continued until May 2023 when she was referred to the Uganda Cancer Institute in Mulago. But luckily for her, she is among the first patients to receive partial treatment and screening at the Northern Regional Cancer Institute, which is still under construction in Gulu City.
In May
2022, I was operated in the mouth at Gulu Regional Referral Hospital. Then they referred me to Mulago, but I could not afford to travel to Mulago for cancer treatment. Then they asked me about my relatives, but they were all murdered during the war. So I came here, and this is the clinician who welcomed me, and he has promised to take care of my condition.
Achiro Lucy is a clinical navigator at the Northern Regional Cancer Institute. She is the officer who received Beatrice Alworoto, and they are conducting further tests on the patient's condition.
Out of the 36 patients, they are in categories. They are those whom, like for her case, she was the diagnosed cases in the community and they have not received treatment. We are among the 36. Then there are those who were on treatment from Cancer Institute Kampala, but they could not now continue with their treatment because of financial constraint and arrest.
Every year, 32,000 out of 100,000 people get cancer in Uganda with an 80% mortality rate. Gulu ranks second to Kampala, and Western Uganda comes in third in the ranks with the highest patient figures.
Gulu already has a registry, and the registry is showing that actually the number of new cases of cancer is quite high here, actually ranking second.
Although the facility has high-tech machines installed, such as the CT scan, X-ray, mammogram, and ultrasound, the construction of the Northern Regional Cancer Institute in Gulu City is estimated at 70%. Dr. Jackson Orem is the executive director of the Uganda Cancer Institute. He says they have been inclined to start partial operations due to the high demand for cancer care and treatment in the country.
And the reason is that most of our patients are in the countryside, and in most cases there are certain barriers that prevent them from accessing care. And the biggest barrier is actually access to.
In Gulu, the most common types of cancer that have been recorded at the Northern Regional Cancer Institute are cervical cancer, prostate, and skin cancer. The Gulu Cancer Facility currently has 19 staff with 4 doctors. The number is expected to raise to 200 staff when construction is complete.
We have a lot more here, the aspect of trade, the aspect of regulations. Who is selling what? Are they teaching people how to use those things? That's what we are facing this side as cancer, by the way. You understand me? So I want us to look at cancer as not an end in itself. It has been as a result of something.
However, despite the promising good future that this facility is bound to provide for cancer patients in Northern Uganda, there is an urgent need for land to construct accommodation premises for the staff and expand the health facility.
We should be able to open up for the public to come and start having the services. We can't wait to reach 100%. Our people need these services. That we had the whole year and a half, no work was being done because of COVID. But now we are on track. The human resource that is going to work here has been approved by government.
The Northern Regional Cancer Institute is expected to help in the decongestion of Mulago National Referral Hospital. It will cost the government of Uganda 3.5 million euros with funding from the Austrian government. The institute is expected to serve the greater north, ranging from Upper Karamoja through Acholi and Lango subregions to West Nile, and the neighboring countries of Democratic Republic of Congo, South Sudan, and Kenya, and beyond. Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.